Hello everyone, myself Pooja Dange and I am from Information Technology Department. So today in this session we have to discuss regarding the database concept. So first I have to tell you student ki what is mean by database. So database is a collection of organized and structured manner data and which will stored in the format of electronic data in our computer system. So inside that database there are the different statements which will provided. So we have to see first is the DML statement in the database. Okay, so before going to DML statement we have to there is a need to create a table. So here I have to create table. So what is the syntax for creation the table? So syntax is the create table, table name, and you have to specify your column list with their data types. Listen students, here you have to whenever you have to specify your column list, that time you have to give the number of column list here. There is a no restriction ki you have to take only one column, two column, like that. Okay, now there is a example for creation the table. Now here I have to create a one student table. So create table student. Now here I have to specify the column list. Here I have to take a first column as a student name with their data type varchar, means here I have to store the string in that column so that I have to take a data type as a varchar, as well as I have to specify here a size of a string, that is a 20, means only I have to enter the 20 character in that column field. Now the second column is the student address column. Same here I have to take a varchar data type, and at the third column is the student mobile number. That field include only a number value, so I have to take here number as a data type. Okay, now we have to see now I have to create that table. Now how to describe the structure of that table? So by using describe command we have to describe our table structure. So here the syntax is describe table name. So here I have to describe my student table. So output is like that. They have to show your column list with their data type also. Okay, now we have to see there are the basic three DML statements. First one is a insert statement, second one is a update statement, and third one is a delete statement. Okay, let's see first insert statement. So syntax for insertion of the record into database is insert into table name values open bracket, inside that you can specify your all the column values, bracket complete and semicolon. Note that student, here whenever we have to end any statement in database, that time semicolon is a compulsory. So I have to also give here one example. See, in previous slide I have to create a table for the student. Now for same table I have to insert the record in the student table. Okay, now here I have to insert into student. Student is my table name, and that table name I have to created in the previous slide, and values, and I have to insert the column record. See, first record I have to insert as a Pooja, because the first column is the student name and that is the string value. And whenever we have to insert any string in the database, that time that string or that particular string will be inside into a single quote. After the completion of one column record you can make a comma. After that I have to mention my address, that is the Thane, and that particular address also I have to mention in a single quote, because that Thane is also a string or alphabet value. After that I have to make here comma, and after that I have to specify the mobile number. That mobile number is a number value or an integer value. That's the reason ki I directly specify that number. There is a no need to insert any single quote before that record. Okay, now we have to see our second statement, that is a update statement. The syntax is update your table name, set your column name equals to your value, means which column you have to update the value, that column name you have to specify here. After that where, and you can specify here condition. Okay, so condition is very important. With the help of that condition your database will update your column values. Okay, now I have to show here one example also. Same here student, previously I have to create a student table. In that student table I have to update the mobile number, whose student name is Pooja. They have to update their mobile number. For that I have to mention the query update student student mobile number that equal to, I have to specify here mobile number, and where I have to specify the condition. Which condition? Which student name equals to Pooja? Only that student will update their mobile number. Same condition will be here, student. Whenever you have to specify your condition, that time you have to pass the string, that time you can use the single quote command. If here you can specify any integer or number, directly you can specify. There is no need to make a single quote between your number. Okay. Now we can move from the delete statement. See, student, suppose I want to delete some record from my previous database or existing database, that time I have to use the delete command. Okay. So syntax for that delete command is delete from table name where you can specify condition. See, student, previously I have to created here table student. Now from that table, that is my existing table, from that table I have to delete some record from the database. Now whenever I have to deleting the record, that time the syntax is delete from table name and where you can specify your condition. Now here I have to delete the record whose student name is Pooja. So that particular record will be permanently deleted from your database. Okay. So here example, so how write down the query for that? Delete from student where student name equals to Pooja. Same rule apply for here. I have to pass string, so I have to take a single quote. And that whenever I have to execute that query, that time that Pooja record will be deleted from your database. That record is deleted permanently from your database. Okay. Now, how to retrieve the record from database? Now, see, we have to see how to insert, how to update, how to delete. Now, suppose I have to need to retrieve, I have to see all the record from the database, means ki how many records I have to inserted, how many records I have to updated here, how many records I have to delete from the database. That time database will provide one command for us. With the help of that command, we have to delete the record from the database. So which command we have to use here? Select star from table name and semicolon. Okay. So for that previous our student table, I have to select the record from that. Select star from, and I have to specify in my table name as a student. So whenever I have to execute that query, whenever I have to execute that command on my command prompt, that time the database will show that type of record. That is, they have to give the detailed record of your database with their proper record. See here, I have to show the output for that query. In my student table, I have to insert only one row record. So they have to show the Pooja and their address and their contact number will be there. Okay. So I hope so ki you have to clear the DML concept, students. Thank you so much for listening.